Hello student, today I am talking about a retrosynthetic approach. This term, you already aware about this term. You already discussed this at TYBSC level. This term generally used in synthetic chemistry. Synthetic chemistry is what? That means you have to synthesize any organic molecule in the lab. Now, why it is needed to go in a reverse direction? Whenever you want to synthesize any molecule in a lab. Now, if you are having a structure of a molecule and you have to think how you can synthesize in the lab, that time this approach is used. Now, the different terms used in this case, the first term is the disconnection. Now, what is disconnection? Whenever you want to synthesize any molecule, generally the term used is synthesis. But now, in the retrosynthetic approach, we have to think in the opposite direction. So if you are going to think in the opposite direction, that indicates we, instead of synthesizing a bond, now we have to think about how we disconnect the bond. Now, what is a disconnection? This is an analytical operation which breaks a bond and converts a molecule into a possible starting material. It is the reverse of a chemical reaction. The symbol used is reverse arrow. Now, the next term used is functional group interconverger. The short form for this is used as FGI. The operation of writing one functional group for another so that disconnection becomes possible. The symbol used for this a reverse arrow, and over that we have to write down the FGI. The next term used in this case is the reagent. What is reagent? A compound which reacts to give an intermediate in the plant synthesis or to give the target molecule itself, that is called as a reagent. Most of the time, this is also called as a synthetic equivalent. The next term used, that is the same synthetic equivalent, a reagent carrying out the function of a synthon which cannot itself be used because often it is too unstable. The next term is the synthon. Now what is synthon? Synthon that are generated during the disconnection, that synthons either positively or negatively charged. As they are charged structure, therefore they are unstable. The synthetic equivalent release the synthon during the reaction course. The next term is used, that is the target molecule. What is target molecule? The molecule whose synthesis is being planned is called as a target molecule, and the short form we return it as a TM. Now, what is the basic concept behind it? Now, whenever a target molecule, we are working in opposite direction, therefore we use transform. When we go for in a reverse direction, we are going with the disconnection approach. And after disconnecting a bond, we generate a synthon. Synthons are either positively charged or negatively charged structures. Now, that synthons are not naturally available. So how that synthons result? That synthons result from synthetic equivalent or reagent. The same thing it is given over here. What are the synthons? What is the synthetic equivalent and all that? Now the disconnection can be of different way. Either we can disconnect a bond in a hydrolytic way so that if you are going to disconnect a bond in this direction, the disconnection that is having a negative charge and this carbon having a positive charge. So we call it as a hydrolytic disconnection. Now what is homolytic cleavage disconnection? That is one electron to this direction and another electron to this direction. That is one electron carry with this carbon, another electron carry with this carbon. That is the homolytic cleavage. And the next transform is the concerted reaction. Concerted reaction that you already aware about the rearrangement reactions. And concerted reactions means the bond breaking and bond formation, they are the simultaneous process. So this is one of the example of a Diels-Alder reaction, what is a 4 plus 2 addition reaction. Now what is the list? Now this list includes donor and acceptor synthones. As I already said, that synthones are positively charged or negatively charged. If I talk about the acceptor synthones means they all are having a positive charge. So you can see here, they all are having a positive charge. So acceptor synthones having a positive charge, and the synthetic equivalent for this, if you are having an alkyl cation, you can have options of either alkyl halide, alkyl tosylate. If you are having an aryl cation, then you have an option of diazotase salt. If you have an acylium ion, then the different synthetic equivalents we can use. So this is the list of a donor acceptor synthone and the responsible synthetic equivalent for this. This list also includes the same, some acceptor synthones and what are the synthetic equivalent for this. Now, whenever we talk about the acceptor synthone and synthetic equivalent, it is generally, you can see this, all those things detail when we start disconnection of different target molecule. Now, this table includes a donor synthones. So what is donor synthones? Now you can see there is a negative charge on the carbon that are called as a donor synthone. Generally, donor synthones are mostly obtained by organometallic reagents. So you can see it's a Grignard reagent, organolithium compound, Gilman's reagent. So generally, this is a Wittig reagent. So you can see generally the all donor synthones can be obtained from the organometallic reagent, and that reagents are again obtained from the metal plus organic molecule. So this is the end of the introduction part, and you refer for this is the designing of organic synthesis by Stuart Quarin.